Welcome back, sweetie. Is something wrong? Oh, I see. Yes, I understand. Christmas time is very exciting, but at the same time, very exhausting. I completely understand your feelings. Every year it's getting harder and harder to get into Christmas spirit and feel like we used to when we were kids. It's alright. No matter how you spend this time, as long as you get to relax and get together with the people you care about the most, it's alright. But just in case you think you still want or need a little Christmas spirit in your life, let me tell you a cute fairy tale about the little girl and the winter whirlwind. One year, the wicked winter witch decided to stop spring from coming on time and make winter the only season on earth. She hid the sun behind dark clouds and covered the earth with heavy snow. So, one morning, the people from a small mountain village woke up and found their houses buried under the snow up to the roofs. They started digging tunnels from their own to neighbors' houses and gathered in small groups to decide what they could do. But no one was willing to go on such a dangerous trip. "I am ready to go," an old man said. "But I'm afraid I'm too old and slow to reach the peak in time. If only I was 20 years younger." "Don't worry, grandfather. I will go," shelter to hide from the frost. "I will not," the girl said firmly. "I have a warm little heart, full of love for everyone. It will save me from the frost." "Go, my child," the old man said. "I know your good heart, and I trust it." The children, who were all her friends, gave her their warmest clothes. "Take my coat," one of them said. "My mittens are so warm. Put them on," said another. "Take my hat, my scarf, my woolen socks, and my boots." Soon, the little girl was ready to go. She waved back at her friend, started for the snowy mountain peak a quick pace. She went further and higher, never thinking about rest. Soon, she was able to see the glittering ice on top of the highest peak. All of a sudden, the whirlwinds woke up from their sleep, and noticing the little figure in the snow, became furious. "Who dares to trespass our property? Let's show her who we are," they screamed. "Let's blow at her so hard until she forgets where she's heading for." And they started whirling fiercely around the girl. But she only huddled into after the other fell on the ground, gasping for breath. "What a strong girl," one of them said. "We are exhausted, and she's not even tired." No human being has ever overmastered us, let alone such a fragile little girl. If we cannot manage ourselves, let's call our sisters, the blizzards, for help. And so they called for the blizzards. Hearing them, the blizzards became very angry. "She will pay for that," they roared and threw themselves after her. It was a long and uneven struggle, but the girl overcame the blizzards too, thanks to her strong, warm heart that never let her feel fear or weariness. The blizzards fell on the ground, breathing heavily. "That's shame," one of them hissed. "We are not able to stop her. Let's call our mother for help." "Mother, mother," they all screamed. "Come to help." Their mother was the Frosty Winter Witch. She came at once and said, "I saw everything. Now, listen to me. When you cannot defeat someone by force, turn things the other way around. Let's be good to her." "What do you mean, to kiss her?" a whirlwind asked ironically. "Nothing of the sort," the Frosty Witch said. "Let's just try to be polite and kind, so she will never suspect us of any evil thoughts." So the winds stopped and the blizzards went away. The Frosty Winter Witch appeared before the girl in like a beautiful young woman in a sparkling white gown, with long white hairs and a crown of icy diamonds. "Am I dreaming, or is this some miracle?" the girl thought. "This beautiful lady has the face of my dear mother, and I can hear her sweet voice singing my lullaby. Oh, how I want to hear some more. I will sit here for a while," she said to herself. "I'm so near to the palace. No more than an hour of walking left. I'll be on time." The little girl sat down and closed her eyes. The Frosty Winter Witch grinned in the light. Then she left the sleeping girl on the snowy hill and flew away to tell her children how she managed to deceive the girl. The little girl was sleeping, smiling happily. But the color of her face was changing as time passed. Her pink cheeks became at first red, then blue, and then waxy yellow. She was slowly freezing, until all of a sudden something stirred the snow. A squeaking sound was heard, and a tiny head showed up from a hole in the snow. It was a little white mouse, her shiny black eyes fixed on the sitting figure. "Someone is in trouble," squeaked the mouse, and right after that, a number of little holes opened in the snow, and a number of mice peeped out of the holes. little and their labor so inefficient that they decided to call their friends, the rabbits, for help. This time, bigger holes opened in the snow, and a number of white rabbits peeped out and ran to the rescue. From the snow-covered pine trees, a number of squirrels jumped down, and soon the girl was covered with white and brown fur all over. The little animals warmed her up with their own furry bodies. They were extremely happy to see her cheeks becoming pink again. Soon, the girl opened her eyes. She thanked all of her new friends for saving her life and told them why she was here and where she was going. "We are coming with you," the animals cheered. "We also suffer very much from this never-ending winter." Flocking around the girl, the animals accompanied her to the ice palace. There, they all knocked at the gate, but no one answered. "What might have happened to Father Frost?" the animals wondered. "Let's try to open the door. It's not locked." They opened the heavy gate, and the girl stepped in, followed by her friend. Glittering, icy corridor led them to a big crystal hall. And there, on a gorgeous throne of carved ice, Father Christmas was fast asleep, sitting on his icy throne, dressed in silver embroidered clouds. Two squirrels jumped in his lap and tickled his face with their fairy tails. A mighty sneezing sound made them all freeze with fear. But Father Christmas opened his blue eyes and smiled. "What are you doing here, little friends?" The girl told him everything. "You mean I have slept here while the wicked Winter Witch was trying to stop spring from coming? Throughout the whole winter?" Father Christmas asked, astonished. "I guess she decided to outsmart me and stay on her forever. But I will not let her. Thank you, little ones, for waking me up. Now I will restore the natural order and give everyone what they deserve." Then he blew on his silver whistle, and in an instant, all his subjects appeared in the big crystal hall. He ordered them to go and find the frosty Winter Witch and bring her to the palace so he could lock her down in the cellar until next year. He also told them to clear the skies from clouds so that the sun could melt the snow. When the big gates opened again, the sun outside was shining and the soft snow had started to melt. The way back was much easier. The new friends parted, promising to help anytime when needed. Everyone in the village cheered, meeting the brave little girl. They were very happy to pick the first snowdrops and give them to her. Spring was also very happy to hear the songs and see the dances the children had prepared specially for her. And here we will end. Are you sleepy yet? Sleep. or take a nap if you can. Naps are good. Night, night. Thank you for listening. I hope you found this story interesting. I shall read another one soon. As always, I would like to thank all my patrons for supporting my work. It truly does make a difference. So, thank you. Especially my pink patrons. Brandy. Diet Jelly. POV Degenerate. Honey Badger. Lord Putano. And Martyr. Happy New Year.